Grand Seiko is just full of surprises this year, and while many people are still patiently waiting for the SLGH005 White Birch, which has the 9SA5 high beat movement, to be delivered, a new modified version with the 9RA2 Spring Drive is now available. If you aren't familiar with the 9RA2 caliber, this is Grand Seiko's 5-day power reserve Spring Drive caliber. That isn't all though. This watch actually has a surprising amount of changes made to it, and it isn't just another White Birch with a different movement. We will go over all the differences between the Birches today and help you determine if this is the Birch's true form, and if this could possibly be the true successor to the Snowflake. What's up everyone, it's Chris with the Little Treasury Channel. Welcome back. This is where we bring you awesome watch content at least once a week. If you haven't already, please make sure to smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell to be alerted as soon as we upload. I'm from Little Treasury Jewelers, which is located in Gambrills, Maryland. And it's where you go when you're in the know. As always, the watches that I review are for sale and can be purchased, so please see the description below to contact us. If you're just joining us, I'll go over the watch's detailed measurements and features, and then I'll offer my humble opinion at the end. In our last video, we reviewed the Seiko SLA055, which is the ultimate form of the Baby Marine Master. This one is a limited edition of 1,300 pieces and has a surprisingly low profile. If you would like a top-tier diver that swims stealthily under the radar, then I recommend checking out this video. Wrist check time! The Snowflake's back, everyone, mainly because we'll talk about it later in the video and compare it to the new Birch. This one will actually be the star as well, of course. So tell me which watch you're wearing while you're watching the video and make sure to tell me why. In this video, I'm going to focus on the SLGA009 and we'll chime in with the differences between it and the SLGH005 as they apply. Now let's get on to the features. The SLGA009 White Birch has a 39.8mm case width, a 12.2mm thickness, a 46.7mm lug to lug, a 21.8mm lug width, a 34.2mm crystal diameter, and weighs in at 177.34 grams. The case is the Series 9 case, which is named after 9 being the highest single digit number. And it is angular with small lugs that have a swoop of matte finish and Zaratsu in the inner crease. The bezel is flat on the top and is brushed with Zaratsu on the sides. The sides of the case are matte finished with drilled lugs for easy strap changes. One slight change here is that you will see a small bevel between the lugs to give it more of a stepped dimension versus the SLGH005. The crown can be found at the 3 position and is screwed down with the GS logo at the top. It is a larger and different crown entirely from the SLGH005. The sapphire crystal is very slightly domed and protrudes slightly above the bezel to help you protect your beautiful finish. This case has been made with a low center of gravity to make sure that this piece sits securely on your wrist. The dial is, of course, the White Birch texture, which is supposed to invoke the quiet mood of the white birch trees found near the Shinshu studio where these watches are made. The difference here from the SLGH005 is that the SLGA009 has a less aggressive texture, and instead of a whitish silver like the SLGH005, the dial of the SLGA009 is actually a shiny white. The chapter ring is thicker on the SLGA009 and has some blank area between the black minute grain and the bezel. The Grand Seiko logo can be found at the top middle portion applied in silver, and Grand Seiko written beneath it in black. The markers are part of the Series 9 style, which are broad and easy to read, in Grand Seiko's perfect high polish. The hour and minute hands are Dauphine style, and the hour hand has a chopped off tip, with an indentation down the center. The second hand is blued, and now has a cap at the tip of the second pinion, versus an exposed silver pinion tip on the SLGH005. The date window can be found at the 3 position and is slightly larger and also has a slightly bolder font than on the SLGH005. A big change here is that the black mark to the right of the date window is now gone on the SLGA009. Spring drive and 5 days can be found in black at the lower middle portion of the dial. No lume can be found on this piece, however, the markers will pick up light until it's very dark. The case back is open with a Ghost Lion logo in the center, and we can see the power reserve indicator. It is powered by the brand new 9R A2 caliber, which is Grand Seiko's upgraded spring drive movement. It now has an accuracy of 10 seconds per month and a power reserve of 5 days. It has 38 jewels, dual size barrels, and an offset magic lever to make it even thinner. This movement achieves the extra accuracy by using a sophisticated thermocompensator that checks and adjusts for changes in temperature 540 times per day. If you aren't familiar with the spring drive, it is basically a spring-powered movement that is regulated by a quartz crystal that has an electromagnetic braking system. The movement's finish is made to represent the frost that winter brings to the trees in the surrounding environment of the studio where this watch was made. The bracelet is completely matte finished and is a three-link design. It tapers from a 22mm to a 20mm at the clasp, which has a GS logo on it. The buckle is a folding pusher style and does not have a micro adjust. The SLGA009 White Birch is 100 meter water resistant and is ready to be your ultimate companion for $9,100. Now for my humble opinion. So in my original White Birch SLGH005 video, I thought that maybe it would be a great competitor for the Snowflake, even though it's quite a bit more expensive. And while the comparisons have arose and the piece itself just isn't very readily available, it really is a much different piece with a more silver dial and a high beat movement. I think that the true successor, given time, is the new White Birch, the SLGA009, which if you look, really has a subtle texture and white dial just like the Snowflake. It also has the spring drive, but a better version of it than the Snowflake, with greater accuracy and a longer power reserve. The only thing that it is lacking is the titanium, but I think that most people will be okay with the steel in this situation. I'm not going to sugarcoat this. I really prefer the SLGA009 over the SLGH005, simply because I feel that this is the White Birch version 2.0, with an updated software that fixed the perceived bugs. Although I've never seen it in person, people online have complained about the accuracy of the 9S A5 caliber. And guess what? Now you have a crazy accurate atomic clock-ish spring drive with a huge 5-day power reserve. The dial is actually white now, and it isn't silver. The crown is bigger, and it's easier to grip now. The SLGH005 is still an amazing watch though, also, and I can see people choosing it over the SLGA009 if they want a deeper, more noticeable texture on the dial, and maybe you prefer the silver over the white. The Series 9 case is of course very comfortable and wears low, which is great for my 6.5-inch wrist. And this piece will be a very great wear in casual times, but even great with a suit. I will go ahead and recommend this new SLGA009 to every single person watching this video. If you can afford to buy this watch, then buy this watch because you will not be sorry. And it is my personal favorite Grand Seiko model that they have made thus far. Thanks for watching today, everyone. I really hope that you enjoyed the video. And of course, if you did, please make sure to smash that subscribe button, give this video a like, and share with all of your friends and your family members too. I look forward to seeing you next video.